All right, guys, we're going to start seated. Thanks for coming today. Sit nice and tall. Let the sit bones press into the mat. And then just a gentle dropping of the shoulders down and back. Let's work on engaging our breath. So we're going to just gently draw the breath down to the lower belly. Feel that area expand. We can use our hands right below our navel, if we want to feel that sensation, start to work on that. We're confident we know how to do our breathing already, belly breathing. Just engage that gently. Notice if you're tightening through the jaw. Start to notice the quality of your breath. So if our breath is already kind of fast and forced, maybe our energy's a little low, our breath will tell us where we're at this morning. We want to meet ourselves where we're at, but then move toward where we want to go. So think about what that is. Where do we want to go this morning? What is our end result that we want from this practice, from this time that we're taking for ourselves? We're going to talk a little bit today about how we can deepen our practice. Meaning how we can find some expertise in the poses, perhaps, but finding what yoga means to us and how it can improve our lives, how we can continue to work on our practice. Because that's what it is, it's practice. We're never going to call it yoga perfect, because that does not exist. About three more nice deep breaths here. Continue to relax any tension that's in the body. Let's open the eyes if we had them closed. Start to work a little into the shoulders. Take some movement to see where we might be tight this morning. We've been doing a lot of sitting, a lot of computer work, or whatever it might have been. Maybe we were on our hands and knees gardening. A lot of that stress collects in the shoulders. Let's take our strap when we're ready. And we're going to take it about shoulder width apart, maybe a little less. And we're just going to start with some lifts here. So we're going to take it in front of us and lift up toward the ceiling, seeing where our range of motion is, and then exhale, bring it down slowly. Inhale, reach. Create a little tension on the straps. We're pulling just gently. Three more times. Inhale, exhale. Try to match the breath to the movement. Nice, big reach up, hold, press toward the ceiling. And then we're just gonna gently go side to side. So create some tension on one side, Let the side body open a little, get into the shoulders more. You don't have to go far. And exhale, let's bring it down. Let's widen the grip a little bit more. So take a little more of that strap. We're gonna go side to side in a bigger movement. So let's lift up. Exhale, drop one arm down. Try to reach up and over with the other as much as you can. Inhale, use core strength, come back to center. Exhale, other side. Trying to reach up as much as we can if we don't have a ton of room in our shoulder joint today. Just go gentle, feeling tightness. One more time each side, keep breathing. Lift back up to center, exhale, down. We'll shorten up the grip again, maybe even a little shorter than before. And we're gonna go side to side. So we're gonna take one arm straight and the other arm is going to pull across the body. So make any adjustment to your length here as you need. And then to the other side. Just pulling gently into that shoulder joint. And back. Side again. Open one more time each side. Breathe. Expand the breath into the outer part of that shoulder. And last one. And back to center. Let's lift again. Inhale. Exhale, press down. Inhale. Exhale, press down. Last time. We'll do a gentle twist from here. So inhale, lift. Exhale, bring the strap to one side. Still keep that tension on the strap. Inhale, lift up through center. Again, core strength. Exhale, other side. Let's follow this a few times. Again, looking for our range of motion, looking where we have tightness that we can start to work on and melt away. Maybe we've got some fascia that needs to be worked through. Maybe we've got a little pain in the joint. And exhale down. Nice. Let's take the strap behind us. Grab on still with both hands and create that tension a little bit once more. And we're going to tip the crown of the head forward and then lift just a few inches off the mat, higher if we like. But we're going to try to keep some semblance of posture here. And we're going to move. So use core strength, lift back up, the arms come down. And exhale, tip forward, lift, hold and squeeze in between the shoulder blades. Exhale, come back up. And down two more times. And release. Let's take one last stretch here. So we're gonna keep the strap in one hand. We're gonna take it up above and behind the head. So the strap dangles down below. The other hand is gonna go from the other direction and grab up for the strap. So adjust how long it is. Then we're gonna create a little tension, not a ton, but we're gonna try to bring that top elbow up a little more, draw that bottom elbow down. Be gentle. Two more breaths. Try to let those muscles relax. And exhale, release. We'll go to the other side. So strap in the other hand. That one comes down. dangle behind and grab on, and just a gentle pull. Try to keep good posture here. And exhale, release. Let's come back to center. Take that medium grip again, a little less than shoulder width apart. We'll finish up with that same movement. Inhale, lift, exhale, drop down. We'll take a second here to pause and press toward the ceiling each time. So really try to lift up, and then maybe there's a little back bend here. Puff up through the chest and then down. Two more times. We're going to end with that pressing up, hold. And then exhale, we're going to bring it down to the heart, and we're going to slump the shoulders forward, draw the chin down a little bit. So think of this like a cat-cow. Inhale, reach up, come to what would be cow pose. Exhale, round. Keep that tension on the strap. Two more times. Move slow. Nice. Lift. And then set that down. Put the strap off to the side. Let's take a moment here in our seat. We're going to bring our hands behind for cross-legged sunbather pose. Take the shoulders over the wrists. Draw the head back a little bit, open the chest. Breathe into the heart space. We could maybe take some side-to-side movement here if that's going to feel good into our shoulders. And slowly lift up, use core strength, draw forward, seated forward fold. Keep the sit bones pressing into the mat. Reach forward with the crown of the head. Still decent posture here, not rounding too much. Feeling that long opposition, gentle opposition. Sit bones to the crown. And then exhale, draw the hands in. And let's just take our head and let it slump down. Rounding the back here if we need. A couple more breaths here, just no tension. If this isn't comfortable, if it's causing some pain, maybe take the head and hands. Two more breaths. Slowly walk the hands back up, drop the shoulders back. Let's come to tabletop. Stacking the joints as always. Spread out the fingers. We're gonna take a tiger pose. So we're gonna lift one leg, keep the knee bent, press the heel up toward the ceiling, maybe look up a little bit. We'll hold for a couple breaths, and then we're going to draw that knee into the chest and hover it off the mat. Exhale, let's do that. Draw that knee through. Bring your nose toward your knee as much as you can. Inhale, lift. Open the chest. Reach up with that heel. Exhale, drop it through. Keep moving. Take a couple more rounds. Nice. Always an option to bring that knee down if we need to. Lift last time. And exhale, set that leg down, other side. Inhale, lift, open, take a moment. And then we'll start our motion. Exhale, draw through, nose toward knee. Keep breathing. Try to keep the hips fairly level here. And last time, lift and set that down. Let's come to child's pose, widen the knees a little if you need. Shift back, exhale, drop the hips down. Reach forward if you like, four arms at the sides. If you need a little bit more stretch into the shoulders, you've already done a lot, but if you need a little more, come up onto the fingertips, lift up the elbows a bit. If you really need some more space, you can use blocks here, but I wouldn't recommend that unless you're really not feeling it in the shoulders. Breathe. Two more breaths. Nice. Let's shift forward from here. We're going to come all the way forward to a kneeling plank. Shoulders even more forward and slowly down, chaturanga. Then we'll take a little baby cobra pose. Option here to lift hands up off the mat, just use back strength. Otherwise, pressing into the mat, keeping the elbows bent. Exhale, come down. Let's lift up through our kneeling plank, shift back, child's pose. Exhale, draw all the way back. Two breaths here, then we'll take that motion again. Inhale, come forward, and slowly down. Take a back bend here, either version, hands down or hands up. Slowly shift back, child's pose. Two more times through this cycle, keep breathing. Last time as we shift up, we're going to drop our elbows down to the mat, become two cup and stretch. Hips are high, forehead can come down. If you need some support on blocks with your forearms, so your head isn't pressing into the mat too far, you can do that. Drawing back. Keep working on straightening the back, especially the lower back. So our opposition is here, so crown of the head to the hips. Let's take a couple more breaths here. Let's think a little bit about what might be blocking us or preventing us from getting deeper into our practice. Is it our flexibility? Is it our mood? Is it our time? What factors and barriers are preventing us from getting a little deeper into our practice? Inhale, let's come up, shift forward. We'll come to lie down all the way to the belly to Sphinx pose. Draw the shoulders back. Hip points pressing into the mat. Neck is nice and long, not too many wrinkles on the back of the neck. On an exhale, we're going to bring the head all the way down. Reach the arms forward so the forehead can be on the mat. Pointing the toes behind us. Long line here. Fingertips all the way down to the toes. Two more breaths. Let's release the hands. Bring them under the shoulders, press back, and we're going to come to downward facing dog. Take any movement you need to here. Press the heels down, maybe shift side to side. Settle in to our down dog. There is strength in this pose, but there's also some surrender, especially if we're tight to that posterior chain. Keep pressing back toward the heels. Two more breaths. We're gonna take a twist from this pose. So let's take one hand and plant it in the center of the mat. And then if we can come up onto the fingertips of the other hand, start to lighten that side. And then if we feel comfortable with our balance here, lifting up that arm, reaching up toward the ceiling. Still keeping pressing back with those heels. And then exhale down. Move the other hand toward the center of the mat. And then lighten the load on those fingers and potentially lift, open up to the side, good. Exhale down, do that one more time each side, keep breathing. Head down, and last side, inhale, reach, and down. Let's shift the hips high, come forward to plank. Option for knee plank here, draw the shoulders back. Hold here for a couple seconds. Yeah, you can do that if you like.
Sure. Might as well get the challenge going.
Inhale, lift the hips, shift back, down dog. Breathe. Hips high again, shift forward, plank. Option here to come to upward facing dog. So we're gonna shift forward a little bit, switch the feet. Straighten the arms more, drop the hips down slightly. Tops the feet and the hands. Switch the feet back, inhale, shift back, down dog. Breathe. This is our resting pose. Always an option to come down to the knees if you need to. Last one, shift forward, plank or kneeling plank. And then a little hold here or option for upward facing dog again. Draw the shoulders back. Switch the feet, shift back, down dog. Breathe. And then slowly walk the feet to the hands, forward fold. Let all the tension drain out of the body. Bend the knees as much as you need. Inhale, come up halfway, straighten the legs. And exhale down. Option here to take the hands to the lower back. Working a lot of shoulders today, really trying to get loose through the shoulders if we have tension there. And then option here to interlace the fingers, lift the hands up off the lower back. Reach up, think humble warrior. Be gentle. Exhale, release the hands, drop them down toward the mat. Inhale, come up halfway, shoulders lie back. Exhale, forward fold. Rock side to side a little if you need. Option here to move the hands over to one side. Little twist, and then move them to the other side. Do that a couple times. And then back to center, inhale, halfway lift. Big breath. Exhale, forward fold. Bend the knees a little more, lift all the way up, hinging at the hips, reach. Exhale, arms down to the sides. Cross the arms, inhale, lift. exhale across. One more time. Arms out to sides, mountain pose. Tadasana. All right, now that we're good and warm, we're gonna move into our sun salutation or Surya Namaskara. We'll talk about the Sanskrit names for the movements in this, just to refresh our memory. So we're in Tadasana right now, mountain pose. We're gonna inhale, come to Utthita Tadasana, extended mountain pose. Exhale, come to forward fold, which is Uttanasana. We're gonna take the right foot, send it back, or runner's lunge, Anjaneyasana. Left foot shifts back, coming to downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, come to plank, Balakasana. Shift forward and down, Chaturanga Dandasana. Cobra Bhujangasana. And down, back to Adho Mukha Svanasana. Lifting the right leg, we call this Tripada Adho Mukha Svanasana. Very long name, which means three-legged dog, basically. Shift that leg through, coming back to Anjaneyasana. Right leg forward. Yes, exactly. Feet together, forward fold, Uttanasana. Bend the knees, reach up, Utthita Tadasana. Exhale, sit back, Utkatasana. Chair pose. So we'll go through those again. Feel free to repeat if you like. After I say it, inhale, reach Utthita Tadasana. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Right foot back, Anjaneyasana. Left foot back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Coming to plank or kneeling plank, Balakasana. Exhale down, Chaturanga Dandasana. Cobra Bhujangasana. Exhale down, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Tripada Adho Mukha Svanasana. Anjaneyasana. Uttanasana. Forward fold. Utthita Tadasana, send it down. Utkatasana, chair goes. All right, let's continue through our flow. Inhale, reach up. And fold. Take this at your pace. Follow me or do the movements on your own. We're going to take another four sun salutations. If you want to do more, that's up to you.
All on the same side.
No, we're switching sides each time. Yeah. Cool. Yep. Okay. Yeah, I think I screwed up on that second one.
It's just that we're moving.
No, we do want to switch.
Consider it harder to start your training.
That's right. Yes. Yes. I was testing you. You passed.
I just ignored.
Refocus. Listening really well to our body through these poses and movements, seeing what our body is telling us about what it needs, about where we have pain, where we have tightness or weakness, and where we feel really good, nice and strong, stretched. Maybe our breath is really good. Maybe our movement and flow is really good. Not just focusing on the negative. Option is always to come to
upward facing dog instead of cobra pose.
Taking whatever we need out of this practice. When we're done, just coming back to our standing mountain pose, Tadasana. Taking our extra long chair pose if we like, that feels good. We want to have that challenge.
That means it's here from the pose again?
That's up to you. And then shaking it out when we're done. So, awesome work, guys. Take your time, don't let me rush you. It might be that he was on in my house this morning.
What?
Yeah, it popped on. I was like,
that's 95.
Yeah, right. It is actually off, so we're good.
We turned it off yesterday.
Yeah, it's off. Should be off.
It was before Marie came in, so she didn't sneak it back out again.
All right, still standing in our mountain when we're done, shaking things out. Take another moment for meditation, scanning the body, breathing. Two more breaths. And release the hands. Let's come to the top of the mat. We're going to come to high lunge. Right foot back. Bring that front knee over the ankle.
I don't trust you.
Keep that. Yeah, you can bring your blocks. We are going to go forward. You're right. Keep that back heel up. Option to lift the arms. If we've done way too much shoulder work for you, then just prayer posture is fine. Drop that knee down a little in the back. Try to settle the stance a little. Pressing firmly into the mat with our connections. Good. So we're going to go right from here to crane stance. So we've got a couple options for that. We're going to shift forward and we can bring the right leg up and have the right toes just pressing into the mat. Option here to lift, keep the toes down toward the mat, reach as high as we can with that front knee. Option to press out the hands to the side for some balance. We're gonna slowly move that leg back, option to take it down, take that toe down, so we're checking in with our balance. Otherwise, shifting all the way back to our high lunge. We're looking for some control and balance in our movements. So shifting forward over that left leg, start to reach with that right knee, lift it up, move slow. Exhale back, get the right spot for that toe to come down. As always, option to set that foot down if we're not comfortable with our balance, and back to our high lunge. We'll do that two more times, move slow. Breathe. Bend that root knee a little bit. Exhale, step back, high lunge. Lift, bring the crane. And then, nice job. Let's lift both arms again. We're going to plant that back heel. And we're going to come to pyramid pose, taking the hands down. So this is where those blocks may come in if you want. Otherwise, hands down on the mat or holding onto the leg, both hands. Your version here. You're finding that you're not able to straighten your legs very much, shorten up your stance a bit. Try to relax the lower back, find any areas where there might be tightness that are preventing you from going a little further forward and holding over that front leg. And exhale, let's drop that back knee down. We're going to come to a low lunge. Release the toes behind us. Press the hips forward, or let the hips drop, I should say, forward a little bit, not pressing and pushing. And then shift the hips back. We're going to straighten that front leg, coming to half splits. You can go deeper if you like, if you have that flexibility. Great. If it is going to work for your hips and your knee, what you may do is sit down onto your heel on the backside, getting a little stronger stretch into that front leg. So this may not be an option for everyone, just getting it, throwing it out there for those who may like that. And we're trying not to move that lower leg too far out to the side, so we're not causing pain to the knee. Two more breaths. And then slowly shifting forward, front foot comes down, curl the back toes under, let's come to runner's lunge. Press back with that heel. And then option for a twist here, pressing into the right hand, lifting the left. Reach open. We can drop that back knee down if we need to. Exhale, release that hand to the mat. We'll go the other direction, so the less common direction. So that left hand's going to be still on the left side of the foot, reaching up with the right hand. Good. And exhale down. Slowly work our way back up. Use your hands on your leg if you need. And we're going to switch feet and work that sequence on the other side. So right foot forward, high lunge, reach, our hands in prayer here. Settling into this pose, dropping that back knee a little. And then taking our movement. So shifting forward and then coming to what we call light leg, so just pressing with the toe. Or lifting up to crane all the way. Arms can be out to sides or up, whatever you like. And then slowly shifting back, planting that toe, coming back to our high lunge. You can always come to a wall as well as if we need some help with our balance for this. Shift forward, lift that leg, crane. And then back. Again, really getting that in the right position, getting that toe down in the right position. Two more times. And exhale back, smooth motion. Inhale left. Exhale back. Plant the heel down, straighten both legs, reach down. Here's our pyramid pose. Release the upper body as much as we can. Use our blocks here if we like. Continuing to draw those legs, both legs straight as much as we can. And again, if we are having a really hard time with that, shorten up the stance, bring that back leg up a little.
And exhale, let's drop that knee down, come to low lunge. Posture of the back is mostly straight here. And then shifting back, coming to our half splits on the other side. Right leg forward this time. Keep reaching, use blocks or whatever we need. We can sit tall and hold onto the leg if that's possible for us. And then option here to sit back on that heel if that works for you. A little different stretch.
That one I don't feel at all.
Really? Okay. Yeah, you may not. You may not. For me, this is pretty intense.
Yeah, for me, this is better.
Yeah. Yeah, pick, absolutely. Pick your version. Yeah. Slowly come up, shift forward, gentle with that knee, curl the back toes under, runner's lunge. Settle into this pose for a moment, breathe. Press that heel back. And then option for a twist, right hand lifts this time, open that shoulder. And then exhale, bring that hand down, and we'll take the twist to the other side, reach. Good. And exhale down. Bring that right leg back to plank. Hold here for a couple breaths. And then we're gonna go from plank right to cobra pose. Let's drop the knees down. Keep the elbows a little bent, but let the hips come down a little bit and let the lower back compress just slightly. Inhale, lift the hips a little more, curl the toes under, coming back to plank. Release down. Bring the knees down, tops of the feet to the mat, and then shift up just a little with the shoulders. Just hips drop. Nice. One more time. Shift back, come to plank. Hold. And then forward, the knees down, coming to Bhujangasana. And shift back. Coming to our tabletop, and then we'll slowly stand up for a couple of balance movements. Take your time. We're gonna slow it down a little bit. We're gonna do Qigong 1. So take a good stance, feet about shoulder width apart. Bend the knees, shoulders back. Arms are going to be a little rounded, fingertips touch at the sides of the leg. And from here, we're going to go through our three movements. If you haven't done these before, follow along. Inhale, lift the arms, keep the hands real loose, elbows are down. All the way back, draw the hands to the shoulders, press forward gently, both hands. We're not going to come to full extension here, so keep some roundness. Draw the hands out to the sides. So if there's a beach ball in front of us, we're going to round the beach ball. And then to the sides of the body, press up 45 degrees, forearms together for butterfly. Draw the fingers together again, exhale, draw down. And then fingertips toward the ceiling, again, 45 degrees here for spear hands. Then we'll repeat those three motions. Inhale, draw back, pull back and press. Inhale out to sides. Exhale to our butterfly. And down, so the underside of the beach ball. And then through spear hands. So it's always around and through. Inhale around the top. Press through the center. Out to sides, inhale. Butterfly. And on the underside, exhale. Experience. One more time,
Cultivating that internal focus, matching the breath to the movement. Exhale, drop the hands down slow. We take another dynamic balance here. So feet close together. And this one is called Golden Rooster Stands on One Leg. So we lift one leg. So like a crane, we're gonna drop that toe down a little bit. And our same side hand is gonna lift up. Fingers toward the ceiling, a little bend to the arm. Reach up with that knee. Exhale, that leg down, and then to the other side. That's really it. So if we need some more help with our balance, maybe just coming to the toe. If we're not feeling confident about lifting that leg, that's fine. And then making this meditative moving from side to side. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lift. Really making sure that we plant through that foot, through that leg that we're grounding into, bending a little bit, working that dynamic movement. One more time each side. And exhale. Let's take a wide stance. We can come to the long edge of our mat if we like. And we're gonna take some shifting movements here. We can bring the hands to the leg. We're gonna shift to one side, draw the hips to that side, bend the knee toward the toes. Shift back through center, inhale, exhale, turn your feet, and then to the other side. Think of this like a warrior, plant that back heel down. Keep moving. At the end of the pose, there's a little chest opener. So draw the shoulders back at the end. Eyes proud of posture. Take this a couple more times on each side. Hand back to center. You can bring the toes kind of a little bit to the outside, so maybe 45 degrees or a little less. Let's inhale, reach up with both hands. Exhale, cross the arms and tip a little bit, still keeping head over heart. These are our sunflowers. Reach and cross. One more big lift, reach. And then exhale, drop the hands down. And then we can sit back. We can come to a chair, a wide-legged chair. Or option four, Malasana, garland pose, which is yogi squat. So we bring our hips all the way down.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why it's an option. Doesn't work for everybody. We're working on keeping our feet flat to the mat. If we can't, that's okay. If this is causing pain or we're really not comfortable here, then work our wide-legged chair for another couple moments. Eventually, if the hips are able to release, this can become a comfortable pose. We're dealing with a lot of tightness in our hips, then this may not be as possible. Exhale, let's plant our hands down on the mat, slowly straighten the legs, be careful with the knees, forward fold, wide-legged. Let the upper body release as much as possible. And then exhale, we're gonna come all the way down to seated, move slow. Nice work. We're going to start with our legs straight. We can have blanket under the knees or something to help We have a lot of tension there. We're going to sit tall within our staff pose. I already mentioned it a couple times in class, but we're using our base and dynamic tension here. So our base tension is at the sit bones right now, and the dynamic tension is that lifting of the crown. So creating that opposition. Very good for posture, very good for our strength and stretch. Let's exhale, take our hands behind, and we're gonna bend our knees, bring our feet flat to the mat, and bring them a little wider, maybe to the edges. And we're gonna come to a modified deer pose from here, so a little internal hip rotation. Let's drop the knees over to one side, and then we can change the intensity of this by how far our foot is from our knees. So if we wanna go a little further, we can lift that leg out to the side. My torso is still gonna be pretty much facing the short edge of the mat. But letting that top leg come down a little bit more, feeling that rotation in through the hip. Nice. So we're letting gravity do most of the work here. We're not trying to press with muscle because that's going to create more opposition for this pose, which we don't want. We want to allow ourselves to get a little deeper. Three more breaths. And other sides of let's lift, drop the knees over the other way, and then open up that foot a little wider if you need, creating more space there. And then maybe bending the elbows a little bit to feel that stretch more into the hip flexor if we need. More breaths. And release, come back to center. We'll sit tall again, come to butterfly. Feet together. Good posture again, let the knees come down. And exhale, we're going to round the back and fold down. Let the shoulders droop as much as they like, your head can droop. Again, if this is causing pain, like with our earlier pose, you can bring your head to your hands. Slowly come up, straighten the posture again, and we'll straighten the legs and scooch forward, come back to lying on the back. And we're going to take a reclined pigeon pose, but a couple options here. So we can just take our ankle over the opposite knee, or we can work on drawing both knees together, give us like a shoelace pose, and then drawing both knees back. Option here also to grab onto the toes. This may not work for everybody. And drawing the feet in towards you. As long as we can lie down on the mat, that's okay. Yeah, very good. We'll be here for a few more breaths. Try to release into the pose. As before, relaxing muscle, we're not pushing against our stretch here. Just letting that stretch happen. Holding ourselves up where we need or creating tension where we need. With the arms here specifically, but otherwise really, really relaxed. working on finding those restrictions, very important, realizing where we're holding tension, realizing where we're stopping that energy from being allowed to occur. That is potentially what is preventing us from getting a little deeper into the practice. Let's come to the other side. So slowly release the hands and release the legs. And then wind up on the other side. Whichever version you like here. Use that traditional crossover leg or shoelace, reclined shoelace, basically. Three more breaths. Really getting deep into this one. And slowly release. And from here, we're going to come right to our Shavasana. Option for legs up the wall, either free standing or actually against the wall. There is an option, if you do want to try free standing, to take the block underneath the sacrum and lift the legs up. If that's comfortable for you to do. So that's one version of legs up the wall. Or we can just come to our regular old Shavasana and release all tension. Get the legs.
Yeah, another option is supported bridge if you like. Just taking that block under the sacrum.
Try to relax as much as possible. Some of us do have our legs lifted and using a little muscle there, but just the minimum, only the minimum to be lifting up. Part of yoga is finding that relaxation, even if we do have to provide some effort to stay in a pose. That is very core to our yin class, especially our yin practice. Finding that balance between relaxation and effort. While we're in our final pose, let's think back through our practice today. How we think we did without creating judgment on ourselves or comparisons with others. Thinking about things that we could improve without having a lot of negative self-talk. Something that I read this week in an article was that if you stay in your head with all of your thoughts and feelings, the part of your brain that is taking over, you are thinking about things, can often be very negative. That's where that negative self-talk originates, is when we are kind of just keeping everything inside and we're not communicating. So allowing ourselves to communicate, it doesn't have to be with another person. It could be written or just speaking out loud to yourself, honestly, allows that process to move to part of the brain that does more rational thinking. So we can release any of those negative thoughts and be a little bit more balanced, logical about that, not just relying on emotion and fear. So that's one thing that we could do. We could work on communicating or improving our communication. Let's take five more slow, deep breaths right here. Releasing any remaining tension. And when we're done with our five deep breaths, rolling over to our side, bringing our knees toward our chest, with a strong exhale. We can take our blocks out if we've got one underneath us. Letting all the effort of our practice kind of settle in. Feeling those benefits that are going to be with us through the next several days, potentially. All the stuff that we worked hard on today. Certainly physically, but also mentally, spiritually, and maybe even emotionally. Let's slowly come up to seated. Take your time. Sit nice and tall. A lot of good grounding today. We're going to use the sound of the lowest chakra to finish our practice, which is Om. So feeling that energy vibrate through the mat, through our root, and into the floor, which is supporting us and our mat. Release the breath that we have, and then big inhale, say Om. Thank you guys so much for coming today. Hope you enjoyed and that you enjoy this nice weather. As a reminder, I will be not here next Saturday. I'm going to a yoga conference in the Twin Cities for 4 days, which should be really cool. And I'm going to learn more about restorative yoga, which is fun. And then, so I'll be here Wednesday, but not Saturday. And then the following Monday, the 6th of June, is when my 7 p.m. Yin class begins. And that's going to be bi-weekly. So I hope you guys can join me for that. If you have questions about yin and what that is, let me know. Have a great weekend. Namaste.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you.
And I was going to say, I'm a little crazy in truth. Just say, I am enough. I have enough. I'll be taken care of.
That's, yes. Yeah. That's a great mantra. I like that.
I did that when I went through cancer. That's, you know, crazy.
Yeah, and if you say those things out loud,
yeah,
your brain can't tell the difference.
Right.
you're able to trick your brain pretty easily into believing things.
Thank you, John. Have a good day.
Have a good one, Chris. We'll talk to you soon, okay?
Okay.
Good.